Christopher Boy here with a new episode for The Walking Dead No Man's Land. So this is the second episode. As you can see, I got the newcomer's bonus. And at the moment, I'm just going through and looking to see what's available to me at the moment, which isn't very much at this time. So I'm putting down trying to do the resource tent. Now I had to use gold in order to do so. Almost finished with the Road to Terminus mission. We have Ricardo right here. I'm about to train him and let him level up. I think I'm going to go and do the radio tent at the moment. Yeah. The voiceover is done after I had already recorded the video itself, along with added the music. I didn't want to get into any copyright issues, so I deleted all the sound and then put my own music from the YouTube sound library into it. Here we have Brian. He's one of the ones with the bats who can stun the people, or stun the walkers. I'm still thinking about doing the little YouTube ad thing to get more stuff, but I'll do that off camera. Here we're going to train Joel. Good thing it only takes 20 seconds for each one. In the meantime, I can go through the little menu here and see what I can possibly do. And here I think I'm going to be getting the walkers from the sidelines. Okay, now we're continuing on with the Road to Terminus, Chapter 1. I haven't tried any of these challenges yet, but maybe I'll try one next time I play. I have a suspicion they're going to be a lot harder than the regular missions. So we have Anne, Ricardo, and Ken going into the battle. I try to limit the little load times by taking those out of the video. It was a lot longer than that though. And here we're sneaking up on the walkers, or trying to, and so I can check up on the little dumpster things. Moving that, you can see it had got the visual of the four walkers behind it, because they were hidden before. And Daryl, of course, came in and saved the day by getting rid of four of them at the same time with this trusty crossbow. And we're going to save Angie now. In the meantime, as Daryl is doing that, I get to take care of the walkers that's going to surround us. So that's always fun. Good thing I put my characters into the positions there, because that was a perfect places to put them to take care of the walkers. And here I'm just running to the exit. And here we run. There are 13 walkers dispatched. That's pretty good, I think. I need to start equipping my characters with the items I find. And then there's Angie. First we get to unlock Daryl, but Angie also joins us in the camp and tells us where we need to go next. So now we get to have Daryl in our party, which is pretty cool. He's one of the leaders. And I'm not going to read what he just said, but you can see it on the screen for yourself, which is pretty funny. So from this point on, I get to put Daryl in the party, so that's what I'll be doing pretty soon here. Nanji is telling about a military army base that's been abandoned and overrun with walkers. So that's the next mission to go through. And I think here I exchange one of the other two with one of them with the bat, so I can have one of each type of character. Yeah, I switched Ken with Brian, so I'm glad I remembered about that thing. It's good to have different strengths for each character instead of all of them being the same type. And you'll see pretty soon that you can, with two walkers, as you can see here, I got Daryl to, or I was going to have him target one of the walkers behind the first one. And what that normally does is take care of both of them at the same time to lessen the risk. But I moved instead, because I messed up there. That's something to keep in mind if you do play this game, or choose to start the game by seeing my playthrough of it to see if you want to maybe play it or not. And here he's going through and getting more walkers. I think there's more behind that dumpster, whatever that thing is. The large dumpster for metal and stuff. So I had Daryl taking care of that one to give you, or to give the characters more experience points, which are the little sheriff's badge thing that you see. Those are what you use to level the characters up at the training tent. And that's what I was talking about. You can use Daryl or any other ranged character to take care of multiple enemies at the same time. And we have another victory here, and the more experience points you see is there, and fuel rewards. Those allow you to do more missions. And none of these are damaged, so I can go ahead and use them all again. If they are even a little bit damaged, they'll go to the medical tent, so they can heal up a little bit. Depending on how long it'll take, that's when you want to exchange the characters out with other ones. I think each level up your group has, like you as a player get for the whole game, you get two more slots for characters. So keep that in mind when you're getting new characters with the radios, because it'll become difficult choosing which ones to keep and which ones to get rid of. Move my recording app out of the way so I can see what's going on. And here we're going after the trunk of the car because that has something in it. I think I was aiming for both of the walkers, but I wasn't able to get the second one. As you can probably see from the first episode of the series, for each crate you unlock, you get that many crates in the victory spoil things. So if you like only unlocked one of them, you can only get one crate at the end. But if you get all three of them, then you get three crates, or six if you do the little need to go out or watch a video or whatever it is they make you do. As you get you can go behind crate and get ambushed by a walker there. And here I used Daryl to get rid of, or I thought I did. It would have been smart to get Daryl to take care of that walker and then have the other character go onto the glowing thing. That way you'll get a little bit extra experience points for your characters to use. Yeah, here I went ahead and taken care of the little loading screen by editing that out. Sure why I had Daryl open it, but good thing it didn't take too long. And he had a character nearby that could help take care of the walker that came out. And here I had a tiny bit of trouble because there are so many walkers come out and my characters are all spread out across the little map there. here, I went ahead and ran for the exit to keep from getting ambushed by the three behind, or the four, I should say, behind the characters. So once you get back to camp, that's when injured people will get start getting healed. There's only one slot for the medical tent at the moment, so that's something you want to try and upgrade so they can have more slots for more characters. And there you saw I was checking the time of how long I've been playing, the little orange thing in the corner. I don't want the videos to be too long, but this one turned out to be over 25 minutes, so that's still a good time and didn't take up too much space on my phone. So here you see Darren was getting healed and then the other one is next in line. I think here is when I upgraded Brian's equipment. No, I guess I didn't. I should have done so though. And then you can see, I think the 4 minutes is for the medical tent. Went ahead and grabbed that level up kit, which is pretty cool. If you look up in the left hand corner, the upper left hand corner, you'll see I'm at almost at level 5, so that's something I was trying to do for this one in the next episode, is get up to level 6. That way I could level up the council thing. Not sure why I keep going to that little YouTube play button at the bottom right hand corner, because each time it's the same thing, so I guess I was looking at deciding on whether I want to do it or something, I don't know. And here we go with the next one. So I think I had Brian go up and try and undo. Yeah, I did. That way Daryl would be free to shoot from a distance, and then Anne, she could use her weapon more effectively than a bat could use against the walkers. A lot of the knife attacks are one-shot kills, while the bat uses maybe, I want to say 2 to 4 or 5 hits. As you can see, we have a lot of walkers coming out. I did get into a bit of trouble here with all of these walkers surrounding me. Not notice that bag up there near the upper left hand corner. I did not notice that when I was playing, so I'll keep an eye out on that for the next time I get in trouble. Maybe that's like a healing type of thing. I think think here I'm just trying to get as many. No? I figured I would get as many as I could before I left the area. Then the rest of the time I'm in the camp, I believe. Maybe one more battle. I don't remember though. So here I'm just replacing Anna with Ken so I can continue on with the next mission. So I did do another one. In this one you can shoot them through the fence or hit them with the knife and still be protected from getting attacked with them. I should have brought two knife wielders here, that way I can be more productive, I guess I can say. Although I think I did use Brian for opening the fences or gates or whatever. And again, maybe not, but at least they were taken care of. And I believe I have Ken just sitting there as backup for Daryl in case any of them got too close. Here he took out three at the same time, which is pretty cool. I should have had Daryl take care of both of those and then have the other one get a different one. At this point I think I was heading toward the exit, but Daryl still gets some behind him, so they cannot surround them all.